what's up, guys? In this episode, we're going to talk about catch cans and why you need one. But first, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on future episodes. And if you want to support the channel, check out our Patreon page. Catch cans. You hear about them all the time, but you're not really sure what they do or if you need one. Well, let me start by stating that I recommend to anybody who wants to aggressively drive their car that they get a catch can as their very first mod. Why? Well, catch cans are a preventive device and can also be a performance mod. Now, some of you might think that sounds ridiculous. Don't worry, I'll explain why in a minute. So what does a catch can do? Well, a catch can catches oil and prevents it from going back into your engine. Wait, what? Engines have a positive crankcase ventilation system, which everybody simply calls the PCV. This system allows the pressure that gets built up in the crankcase to be relieved. It also allows other things like moisture and fumes to be evacuated as well. I won't get into exactly how this works because that's not the point here, but it relies on vacuum from the intake manifold. Now, most PCV systems will be redirected back into the intake manifold, which means anything that escapes from the crankcase will end up in your cylinders. This means that you're burning oil. And over time, this oil will coat the intake manifold, intake valves, and tops of the pistons. Over time, the sludge builds up and will kill performance. Dirty engines are not happy engines. This is where a catch can comes in. Catch can sits between your PCV valve and your intake manifold. Any oil, moisture, and other contaminants that would normally come out of the PCV valve and go into your intake manifold will now flow through the catch can first. And the job of the catch can is to prevent this crap from getting back into your intake. Catch cans have different designs. Some are just empty cylinders with an inlet and an outlet and nothing else. Some have a mesh on the inside that only lets air pass while trapping particles, and some are baffled and some have a combination of the two. This is an example of what a catch can does. This is from my Genesis after 4 weeks of aggressive driving, including one track day. Now, if you're thinking that you're exempt because you have a brand new car, think again. I only had 10,000 miles on the engine when I took this photo. So there seems to be a lot of confusion around catch cans and how to hook them up. But they're very simple devices with very simple installation. The hardest part of installing a catch can is finding a place to mount it. There are two parts to the PCV system. The inlet, also called the vent, and the outlet, or the PCV valve. This is why you see the PCV valve routed to the intake manifold and the vent routed to the intake tubing or the air box. The PCV needs a catch can whether you're naturally aspirated or boosted. The vent side may or may not need a catch can depending on your setup. Now, on NA cars, in general, you don't need a catch can on the vent and you can actually just run a breather. Some people get confused because they see oil from the vent. This is because at wide open throttle, the air going through the intake passes over the vent tube and creates a type of suction. If you put a breather on the vent, you won't see any more oil, assuming you have a healthy engine. And if you do, then you have another issue. If you have an older motor or have issues with your rings, you may have excessive blow-by at wide open throttle, which can force oil out through the vent, in which case you would need to add a catch can to the vent side. For boosted cars, the PCV valve is closed under boost to prevent pressurizing the crankcase, but pressure still builds up. And where does it go? Through the vent. So for boosted cars, it's recommended that you also have a catch can on the vent side in addition to the PCV side, even on a healthy motor. So how much should you spend on a catch can? Well, that depends on you and your car. I use a cobalt water oil separator for an air compressor on my Genesis and my truck. I bought them at Lowe's for $15 plus another $5 for some brass fittings, and they work just fine. I run an MPX can on the SRT4 and paid about $110. Some people pay upwards of $350, and that's really a personal choice. But just because it's more expensive doesn't mean that it's better though. However, it doesn't mean that cheap ones are okay to run either. For example, I bought a basic can from eBay, like this one here, to run on my Chevy Cruze, and I kept having problems. Eventually, I took the can apart and found that even though the fittings were half inch on the outside, the ports were actually only about 5 millimeters on the inside. So there's a severe flow restriction. So just do your research, don't cheap out, but also don't think that you have to buy the most expensive catch can that you can find. Now, as I mentioned, this is one of the first mods anyone should do to their car. Not only is it a preventive maintenance mod, but it can also be a performance mod. Now again, that might sound ridiculous, but if you think about it, it makes sense. Hot oil going into your cylinders has the potential to cause knock. Now when the car detects knock, it'll cut timing, which means you're losing power to some degree. Plus, oil buildup on the valves will add to flow restriction over time and can cause valve to stick, and the oil being burned can cause carbon buildup on the piston tops, which may cause hot spots, again, causing knock. So a catch can may not add any power, but it'll certainly help you keep from losing the power that you do have. All right, that's it for this episode. Be sure to subscribe, and if this video was helpful, click that like button or leave a comment. Thanks for watching.